Joining me now is Congressman Steve King of Iowa, whom the Cruz campaign has asked to represent them on this issue tonight. Congressman King, welcome to Meet the Press Daily.
Happy to be on. Thanks a lot, Chuck.
Well, let me ask you first a question that Senator Cruz argued about for in 2013. Do you believe his amendment for legalization that took off the table citizenship for the undocumented, do you believe that is a middle ground in this debate when it comes to immigration?
Well, I don't take that position the way it's described, but I would say this, that as I watched that tape and the debate in the committee, and I was aware almost up to the minute what was taking place at the time, it was clear that Senator Cruz, if he was going to make the point and force a vote that there would be no path to citizenship, and expose the objective of especially the Democrats that Marco Rubio had been swept up with, that's about the only way you could draft that amendment. And then I listened to his rhetoric on that, and you want to make an argument that your amendment has the best chance of passing. Then I looked at who voted on which side of that. The border security rule of law people voted with Ted Cruz. The pro-amnesty people voted with Marco Rubio and others. So that's how I would characterize it, Chuck.
Do you believe he was misrepresenting, though, his intentions with the bill? Do you think if that amendment had passed, that would have made this bill pass, both in the House and Senate?
I think that was part of the rhetorical argument to try to get a sway in that. But at no point did Ted Cruz indicate he was going to vote for this bill. I think what's missing here, if Marco Rubio can assign a motive for Ted Cruz, then we ought to also look at the Gang of Eight bill and recognize that it is instantaneous amnesty. It's retroactive amnesty if you've been deported in the past and invites people to come back to America. But also, Marco Rubio and the Gang of Eight do not address the prospective amnesty that's implicit in the bill, which means that if you can get into America after that date, they don't address that at all in the Gang of Eight bill. So I think if Ted Cruz wanted to play the same game on this, he could open that whole avenue up and say that there's going to be no enforcement going forward with people that get into America under the Gang of Eight bill. And that's very troubling to me.
You used an interesting phrase just now. You said, well, he was making a rhetorical argument. Does that mean we shouldn't have taken him at his word there, that he was really looking for a way to find a way to this bill, that we were being naive, or people listening to that's being naive? Because that phrase, rhetorical argument, it's a Washington speak, no?
Well, I've offered a lot of amendments on the floor and in committee, and I've been known to bring some pressure to the other side to try to bring some debate out of them and put them in a place. But that argument that it increases the odds that the bill would finally pass, I think that is a rhetorical argument, and it's meant to be bait for the other side. And when you live in this arena, you hear that, you recognize it for what it is, Chuck.
Look, I hear you. I've been in this town a long time. You've been in this town a long time. But that does come across as a little bit misleading to the average voter. I'm talking about Mr. and Mrs. Voter here.
I wouldn't disagree with that, but I'd like to explain to Mr. and Mrs. Voter that this is an arena in 2013, and if Ted Cruz did something tactically back then that was designed to expose the motives of the people that were pushing this horrible Gang of Eight bill that the American people have rejected, maybe then he should have been thinking about potentially becoming a candidate for president. Is that what we're holding him accountable for here? Not for his positions, because when you look at the people that voted with Ted Cruz on every amendment on the Gang of Eight bill, they're the Jeff Sessions people. That would be me if I were voting in the United States Senate. And it's also Chuck Grassley, the chairman of the committee, and John Cornyn and others that voted with Ted Cruz. So look at the votes. Let the people that were at the table interpret these actions on the part of Ted Cruz. And by the way, we shouldn't really let a presidential candidate turn this whole thing into casting aspersions upon the motives of someone who has been very clear about where he stands. And by the way, I'd ask people also, go read the 11-page document on immigration that Ted Cruz rolled out about 2.5 weeks ago. Right. I had some voice in that. That's real clear, and I wish that Marco Rubio would read that document too.
You know, it's interesting. I actually did read it. I read an interview you did about it about a month ago in National Journal, and you seem to imply that if everything in that plan is put into place, including getting rid of so-called sanctuary cities, that you wouldn't have to deal with the 11 million. It sounds like you believe it would become self-deportation, that at the end of the day, you'd have local law enforcement sending people back, and you don't believe the 11 million would be there after E-Verify got put in. So you're essentially saying there'd be self-deportation, correct?
Well, I wouldn't actually use that word self-deportation. I would say instead that because it includes and brings into this local law enforcement, when people that are unlawfully present in America violate the law and they're encountered by law enforcement, then there would slowly be the enforcement that exists in the law today, and over time those numbers would shrink. I think there would be an existing population that would have their roots would go down and out, that would stay in this country in the shadows. I don't know how big that population be, but I don't think it becomes a problem we have to deal with public policy at that point. And that may be the best solution we can get at the end of this, Chuck.
Is there any compromise you would agree to that would keep the 11 million here, give them some legal status without citizenship?
You know,
I mean you,
this.
Congressman Steve King.
Yes, at me as an individual, I kicked a dent in my filing cabinet in 1986 when Ronald Reagan let me down by signing the Amnesty Act, because I knew what it would do to the rule of law. And it says that if you've got to have respect for the rule of law, it's got to be there in our society and our culture. And when you reward people for breaking it, then you're gone down this. How do you ever then restore that respect again? And I'll say this: Ted Cruz understands that we have to have a policy that restores the respect for the rule of law. And once we get to that point, if there are people left in this country that are here illegally, we can maybe have that conversation. But I think it's a 3 to 5 year endeavor just to restore the respect for the rule of law, and that's going to be a very difficult task given there's been so much disrespect for it in the last several administrations that we've had.
By the way, on USA Freedom Rack, you and Ted Cruz actually disagree. You and Marco Rubio are on the same side of that issue. Have you talked with Senator Cruz and told him, because you believe that the USA Freedom Rack makes it harder to track some of these terrorists? Am I correct?
Well, we've had discussions about almost every piece of policy that there is, but where it is on this is that under the USA Freedom Act, there's 18 months roughly of action to metadata records. And under the Patriot Act, the previous legislation, there was maybe as much as 5 years. That hadn't been accumulated yet, but our intel people tell us the most important part's the first 18 months. So I think this distinction is not a difference that should make the difference between the President of the United States. It's got to be who's going to restore this country, who's going to put the soul of America back together again.
Congressman Steve King, Republican from Western Iowa, thanks for coming on. Appreciate
it. Thank you, Chuck.